I have some good news, Mr. Haggerty. I unmasked your thief.
Nothing to unmask, was there? We all know that the thief was my sister, Catherine.
Actually, sir, the thief was a niffler.
A what?
You know, small, furry, pilfering. I followed it to its lair.
Catelyn was the only one who knew how to get into our homes, where to find our treasures. But I suppose, mangy little blighter. Well, if you found the niffler's lair, as you say, you must have found my heirloom.
I found your heirloom, and I'll give it to you. For a price.
Huh? I suppose that's only fair. Very well. We'll call it a reward. Sounds more decent that way. Catherine's a disappointment for certain, but I never wanted to believe she was behind this. Now, thanks to you, I won't have to. Strange world we live in. Suppose they can't send a niffler to Azkaban. At least I got my heirloom back.
Alohomora.
do we have here? A demiguise. Looks intriguing. I know what that means. Merlin trial. Who's so tricky after all, Merlin?
Any luck with that puzzle?
Huh. mysterious and a bit unsettling. What to do? Ravenia! This looks like the statue Madame Twiddle mentioned. Why are there so many vases around here? I suppose I should try to find all the vases. There should only be a few more vases. Revelio. I'm nearly finished. Only one more vase. That's it. I should tell Madame Twiddle about what happened. I wonder if I'm safe to explore in there. Mrs. Twiddle, your husband was right. The statue was part of a puzzle.
Oh, really? How exciting!
Yes, I had to destroy a number of large vases, and that seemed to activate some sort of charm on the statue.
Well done! Oh, I miss having someone like you around with a thirst for knowledge and a quick mind. Well, my curiosity has been satisfied. Thank you for that. Who knows what I'll encounter on my next constitutional? Oh, my husband would be so pleased to know he was right about that statue.
Thank you. It's you! Just the person I need.
Samantha, is everything all right?
No, no, it's not. It's my brother William, the one I told you about after charms class. He's been cursed. He ignored my warning, and now he's lying in St. Mungo's looking completely pathetic. He simply never listens.
I'm sorry. How exactly has he been cursed?
Oh, you won't believe it. Truly. But his feet were turned into purple beets. You can imagine his distress. And mine. I won't even go into the attention he was getting from our garden rabbits before he admitted himself to hospital.
Beets for feet. How hilarious. I mean, how terrible. Horrible. Truly.
You and the entire school may find it funny, but the situation is dire.
Well, it is an unusual situation. How did your brother end up like this?
It's entirely his own fault. I told him about some research I'd done recently on our ancestor Marmaduke Dale. In particular, my discovery that Marmaduke's tomb was cursed. My brother's always making fun of my discoveries. This time, he laughed in my face. Told me I'd misinterpreted my findings. As if that were possible. And to prove his point, he went right up to the entrance of the tomb, and poof! His feet transfigured into beets.
If I'm honest, I'd say he had it coming.
Normally I'd agree with you, but he's my brother. I know what he did showed abysmal judgment on his part. And no one deserves such a fate to last forever, especially as the result of a single brainless mistake. Now I worry that if the curse isn't reversed, it could become permanent.
Can't the curse be broken?
Possibly. The curse stems from a crest that was stolen from Marmaduke. If the crest were returned to its rightful place upon his sarcophagus, then I believe that William's feet may be restored. You battled trolls when they attacked Hogsmeade, escaped a dragon, and I could tell by your work in charms that you're a skilled spellcaster. Returning a crest to a sarcophagus should be almost effortless for you. So, will you help us?
Why was Marmaduke's tomb cursed?
The curse is the result of an intense sibling rivalry between Granham Dale and his younger brother Marmaduke. Marmaduke was a famed herbologist, and Granham resented the attention that he received.
Sibling rivalry? Sounds as if it might run in the family.
But I would never intentionally curse my brother, not like Granham did. When their mother died, Marmaduke was given the prized family crest. Granham felt that as the eldest child, he should have been given it. Years later, when Marmaduke died, Granham stole it and cursed the tomb so that none in the Dale family could ever pay their respects.
Why is your ancestor so well known?
He discovered the properties of several magical herbs and plants. He also uncovered numerous types of flora. The wizarding world owes him a great debt. His work not only impacted the discipline of herbology, but also potion making.
How do you know it's safe? I don't want my feet to turn into beets as well.
Oh, but the curse only applies to Marmaduke's descendants, as my brother so aptly demonstrated. That's why I need your help. You're unrelated to my family, so the curse wouldn't affect you.
I can take the crest of Marmaduke's sarcophagus for you.
Oh, thank you! Thank you so much! You'll simply go into the tomb where Marmaduke was laid to rest and place the crest on top of his sarcophagus. According to my research, the tomb's been abandoned for centuries, so it should be a fairly simple task. You'll find it just east of the hamlet of Brockborough. Thank you for your help. My family is indebted to you.
I need to find the tomb near Brockborough and place Samantha's family crest on a sarcophagus there. Looks rather dark in there. Never stopped me before.